method in which we tell like which part of the code we want to execute first and which part we want to execute after that.
You are
It
talking
is a design
about,
pattern.
yeah, Bipin.
It is a design pattern where we run execute the script based on the pages and based on the requirement. And one of the biggest advantage is that here we don't need to add the jars. We need to just add the required dependency in pom.xml. So means it is so it will automatically download the jar as soon as it gets loaded.
I'm not talking about that pom.xml. That's something else. Don't be confused that pom.xml is not related to any more page object model. It's actually mapping the name POM, so that doesn't mean those are totally separate entities, separate things. So I'm talking about just asking about the page object model. And the pom.xml is actually part of your Maven, right? So I'm not talking about that. That is already covered, I think. So we are not seeing that this time. So my just concern is to know anybody have idea about page object model design pattern? Nobody has idea. No problem. We are going to see it. I have uploaded the video, right? So you can find in this recorded link. Many times I want to let you know, many times I get messages from many people. You guys are attending, only 10 people are attending this session, but still in your batch 40 to 45 people are there, right? And people keep messaging where my recordings are uploaded, where can I find recordings. This is your Google Classroom, right? And the first file in classwork, you just need to scroll till the bottom, right? And you can find this recording links. Every separate recording is here, okay? You can click on view material and you can see topic wise we have written and given the. And somebody said encapsulation is Java recording in missing displayed, kindly share. So I think Sumit has shared to you or not? Maybe he would share. I will share that. Okay, so here you can see all the recordings present, right? So don't put questions like this, because once I start any session, once I do anything, then I say that this question should not arise. Okay, so in your case, this may not be a problem. So 100% uploaded. Now I'll close this. Okay, see, page object model and pom.xml. Many people while learning at initial stage get confused. See, these are not totally related to each other. Pom.xml have a similar name, just like two Rahul can be there, but that doesn't mean those are from the same father and mother, right? So name could be same for anybody, but pom.xml is something totally different and page object model is totally different, right? And this is one of the most important topic related to your interview. Now whatever you are learning, see, once the framework is started, nowadays interviewer expects us to explain the framework because everybody is learning Selenium, right? Everybody is doing something in his career. But you see, if I talk about the framework, no all buddies are able to explain this. Here people are lagging in interviews, right? So we should at least that much knowledge of interviewer that much knowledge of the framework, so that in front of interviewer we can show at least 2 years experience in Selenium. If you are a beginner, still you can show. Just it's your guts that will help him to make them understand that you are actually having that experience, right? But that will come by practice and that will come by knowing these topics, right? If I talk about what is the difference between XPath and CSS selector, everybody will answer that. Everybody has that answer on his tips, right? But nobody is so perfect in framework. Even day by day, I am learning, right? I'm not that much perfect. See, whatever knowledge we have in our bucket, that's not sufficient. Lots of things to learn, right? So that's why I'm saying that framework is the key topic in interview if you are going for an automation interview. If you are going for manual, that's not a problem. If you are showing 6 months experience in Selenium, then that will not be a problem. But if you are showing 2 to 3 years experience in Selenium, then please pay attention here, okay? Because everybody knows, even if I take interview sometime, it takes me 5 minutes to get it know that whether that person have really 2 years experience or not, right? Just one or two questions, and this questions arises from these topics. These questions arises from these topics. So here you should start paying attention if you want to keep yourself, if you want to keep yourself aside from others, right? If you want to show something extra in you, then now it's time to pay more attention. Okay. So here I am talking about page object model. Let me open any website for reference, suppose Flipkart. See, in Flipkart, okay. So guys, if you have asked something, if you need to ask something, then you can unmute yourself. Till there, you need to
Hello.
just unmute yourself. Yes.
Your screen is not visible.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for letting me know this. Okay, so suppose this is Flipkart. Okay, in Flipkart, you can see this home page, right? If nothing is written here after this domain name, then what it means? This means this is actually home page, right? Suppose I click on this login button. Okay, means there a pop-up open. Suppose I click on this cart, right? This is what cart page. If I go to suppose amazon.com, okay, suppose I go to this cart, right? Or something, suppose I add something here. It was not added.
सर डॉट इन पे जाना है हमें।
ओके, दैट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम. एंड आई चेंज द करेंसी. सपोज आई गो टू शूज एंड आई ऐड दिस. ओके, दिस इज योर कार्ट पेज. ओके, दिस इज सेकेंड पेज. फर्स्ट वन वॉज होम पेज. ओके, नाउ इफ आई गो टू दिस अकाउंट, दिस पेज, दिस इज माई अकाउंट पेज, राइट? द कस्टमर्स अकाउंट पेज, राइट? मीन्स सेपरेट वेब पेजेस आर प्रेजेंट. कैन यू सी दिस योर अकाउंट इन होम पेज? नो. योर ऑर्डर्स इन होम पेज? नो. दीज थिंग्स कैन यू सी इन होम होम पेज? नो. दिस इज योर ऑर्डर पेज. वंस आई विल लॉग इन इन टू इट विल शो मी द योर ऑर्डर पेज. Suppose I go to simple website automationpractice.com. Guys, note this website for your practice purpose. Maybe this will be your project, right? So you should have enough knowledge about this website. Okay. Add to cart, and I went to this. This is your cart page. Okay. Suppose proceed to checkout, and now this will be your checkout page, right? What does it mean? It means that in a single website there may be 20 to 30 web pages. Okay, this is one point of explaining the page object model, right? Suppose in your home page some points will be common. Let me come to this home page. See, this is home page. This header, in if you go to Amazon, this header is common in Amazon, and this footer is will be also common in some pages. Somehow you have seen that while automating something, we have written same locators multiple times, isn't it? Even yesterday's session, we have written our locator two times. When? Because yesterday when we were using the Flipkart, and in Flipkart we were just doing something and writing the same locator two times, right? Suppose same locators I have to use 50 times throughout the project. Then will I write that locator 50 times? No. Because that will be not a good practice, and that will not be a code reusability, right? So in that case, page object model says that for each separate web page, suppose there is a home page, suppose there is a cart page, suppose there is a checkout page, right? Suppose there is a payment page. For each separate web page, there should be a separate page class, right? And all locators should be derived from there, right? Suppose I have to use this search box locator, and this search box you can find throughout the project in redirecting to any page, right? So will you write this that much time you want to use? No, you should write this its locator value only once, and wherever you want to use, you can use there, right? This is the actually code reusability. This is the benefit of the OOPS concept. You can just write once and use many times, right? This is the feature provided by Selenium in form of page object model. Once you write a locator, you can use it multiple times, right? So page object model says that for each separate web page, there should be a separate page class, right? And all locators should be written in particular page class, right? Suppose I am in home page. So all the locators which are present in home page should be written in home page objects class, right? All the locator residing in the cart should be written in cart page objects class, right? I hope I am clear. Right now, how we will do it, we will see in code, right? But I think that this point should be clear to all why we are using this, right? Once we will create a framework, you will see the benefits of it, right? Thousands of line code can be saved using this concept. Okay, I will just give you some brief, and once we'll create the framework, you can check this advantage of this. Okay, guys, few weeks left in this training, so now these key weeks are running up, so just pay attention to this. Okay, so here page object
सर, कैन यू प्लीज टेल द बेसिक मीनिंग ऑफ फ्रेमवर्क?
See, once we will start framework, we will talk about that basic meaning. I can't get your question. Can you explain this?
I mean, what is framework?
We will see all these definitions if in once we will start the framework. Okay, so don't worry about that. What is framework and each and everything, right?
Okay, sir.
Just need to break the word frame and work, then you will understand that. Okay, so but the definition breaking the words comes much clear, but we'll talk about all these things later on once we'll start the framework. Okay, just understand this concept which I am explaining, right? Because this is part of your framework. Framework, you will get it very easily, but the concept that each and every separate entity we are explaining here are key points, right? Nobody will ask you in interview what is framework, right? But expect what is page object model 99% times in interviews, right? So focus on this topic. Okay, suppose I have to go to the search box, okay? And I have to use this locator. So previously we were doing everything where we were doing everything in core, which means main method. Every locator we were writing in main method. Now here in if you are using here, just create a package page objects. In your case, there will be folder in your Maven which will be named as SRC and at last test, right? Test folder will be there. So inside test folder you have to create page object. Don't create it in Java, right? In Java folder, right? Create inside test folder, right? Test and Java, there will be two folder, right? SRC test, right? So just create inside where? Inside test folder you need to create this, okay? Otherwise use this same. Once you'll fix this, we'll see again page objects, and here I will create a class home page. Right now another folder will be your test folder. Suppose test cases folder, okay? And inside test cases you have a class search test. Okay, so first your task will be two lines. Those are, let me copy. Yesterday we session. Just copy these lines and redirect to. Okay, just I need to import the packages, right? डॉट गेट एंड गो टू फ्लिपकार्ट डॉट कॉम। And yesterday we were using to something to close this. Just copy that code. Implicit wait and the close button. I hope you guys remember yesterday's session, right? And just I want to close that button and send some keys here. See. What I have did till now, I have just redirected to the page, right? I've just redirected, just set up the properties of driver, created driver object, and then redirected to Flipkart, right? And then what I have did, just clicked on that close button which appears once we run our script, and that doesn't have any cookie, that pop up form came, right? And we are closing this. For that we have written our locator in here itself, right? And that this is for sending keys in search box. I hope this is clear to all. Now from today onwards we will not write locators in same place, right? Because tomorrow if we have to use this same locator, there is no way to use from here, right? So this search box, if I have to use somewhere else, then we have to write its locator again, and the same thing I have explained, this is not a good practice. Or all locators should be written inside a separate entity, that is page class, right? And for each page, each web page, there should be separate page class, right? So home page objects will have all locators consuming which are present this in this home page. Okay, I hope you are getting it. Okay, so now there is a class helping us by dot by and which locator search. First I will use that close button, right? Close button, when that close button appears, once we launch our script and which doesn't have any history, then that close button comes, right? And this is actually locator for that, right? So here I will copy this from here to here. Okay, so this by is actually a class which is storing your locator here. Okay, and this is only locator, this is not your web element. Okay, so don't be confused of that. Okay, now I have to return this locator to this search class, to this search page, because this wants to click close that pop up, right? I will comment this because I have already written this. Now this is written in this form, and just create a method for it and give the method same as the variable name. just put it void as of now. Void and you want to make it as a web element, right? So here you need to use driver dot find element. Just first declare the web driver. Driver is equal to new web driver. Driver is sufficient, right? Import it. Okay, and then driver dot find element and just return this, because this variable stores all that information, by dot x path, right? So what this is now, this is now your web element, because you have attached driver with it, right? So all the web page information means now this driver is having flipkart dot information, currently not, but once I will pass this through a constructor value, then it will be having that. Okay, don't be confused, I am coming to that. Okay, now see, this driver value is what as of now by seeing this class only, null, right? This driver doesn't have any information about the flipkart.com, and my responsibility is to pass that information here, right? How I will pass this? First, I have to, if I have to use this locator, right? If I have to use this locator, then I need to create the object of this class, right? Here, because I want to click the in that. So if I want to use locator of home page object class, home page objects, if you want to use, then you have to make the object for that. See, you need to pass this driver here first, right? And what we need to do, first of all, this is your web element, right? So here just make this method as web element, right? And just return this. Right. I hope these things are clear. Right, so see, if I will launch here directly, just first let me call it spo dot why this is not coming, let me check. Inside a method, let's close it. Let's create a constructor for this first. I'm explaining this, don't worry. See what I have did. Suppose I passed nothing here. So what was in that case? I will show you that also. See why this warning is coming. Just remove this. Okay. See these lines. Guys got to understand, right? This I have redirected to flipkart.com, right? Okay, now what is this? See, if you want to use the home page objects, you need to create all the home objects means actually web element, right? So if you want to use the web elements of home page, so page object model says all home page web elements should be written inside home page object class, right? So in particular page class, you have to write all your web elements, right? So the search box is actually appearing in home page, right? So I have written inside home page class so that easily I can find out, right? So tomorrow if something gets updated in home page, because see, this is not only about writing inside a single place, right? Suppose something gets changes. I know you 100 places you have written 100 times the same locator. So you have to change in those 100 places also. So not only about code reusability, maintenance will be also taking time in that case. Suppose tomorrow developer comes with some changes inside that particular HTML field of this search box. So you have to change in everywhere, right? So in that case, that's why the page object model says that you have to write in single place, and once you will change in single place, it will be reflecting to all the places wherever you are using it, but because you have just updated in the single place from where the people are using this, right? So this is about the page object model. I have written my locator in this home page object class, this search box locator I have written here, okay? Right? So this is written in home page. So what I have did, just created. Okay. So what I have did, I have just created the locator value here and stored inside in our class, right? And just written in a form of method, right? So just written in a form of method. That method is public because if I want to access inside some other class without inheritance, then that method should be public. Okay, so now anybody can say in my last weekday batch, one person asked the question, why we are creating object of it, right? Why we just extend this home page object class? See, this is single page object class, right? Suppose tomorrow you have 30 web pages, so 30 web pages means 30 classes. And if you have to use four, five of them in this class, can you extend those four, five class? No, because multiple inheritance is not possible in Java, right? So if that multiple inheritance is not possible, then what other things? So other things are that you have to use the hazard relationship instead of the isa relationship. So here we are just created the object. And also there is a problem with the extending this home page object here, and that problem is actually if you do this, then all the methods, suppose in home page you have 150 web elements, so you all those methods will be coming here, although you don't need it, but it's still there. So class is getting heavy, right? So performance is decreasing. So keeping all this in mind, we are doing this, that just created and called this method only. Okay, so this is a benefit of hazard relationship. Okay, so tomorrow if the same locator is getting used in 30 places, I will come here and change here, right? Wherever it's getting uses by calling the method, it will be changed there, right? Because I have to change here and everywhere it will be reflecting. I hope it is clear, right? So this is about page object model, and we are seeing some part of it here, means whatever this I have to use in the best format, we are using this, right? So now this is about closing and then send keys laptop. This is our task. Okay, concept is clear, then it's okay. I will write one more locator because now it's about search box. Right, and in same way, public web element. Why? Because we are returning web element, so we should give the method is web element, not void, not int, because we are returning the web element. So here,
sir, we have all, we should also use dot click function also in the close pop form button.
Yeah, just first understand that. I am coming to that. I have not completed that, don't worry. Search input box. And then return driver.findNode and this search input box. Right. So I hope from today you guys will start using this in practice, because see, as much as you practice, not send keys here, send keys I will not use here, okay, send keys will be used in that place only. So don't.
Hello. Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I did not get the exactly meaning of the this not driver equal to driver. Can you please repeat again?
Who is this?
This dot driver equal to driver. What is the exactly meaning of this line?
Okay. I'll explain that. Anything else related to this topic first? I will come to that later on. Means today only, but after explaining this page object model. Okay, so first understand this.
And sir, why we are using constructor?
This same question I will come to and explain it again, okay. But page object model, you are getting it or not? What I am saying and what I am explaining, if that is clear, I will explain that also. But first, I want to confirm this topic. Everybody is clear with that?
Yes, and all
yes,
part is clear except of this thing.
Okay. So let me first run the script. See. Now, see, this is close button which I have located. Now I have to click on close button, right? This is clear. And then spo dot next method what search input box, and inside search input box I have to send keys, and send keys is laptop, right? See what I have did, just located this close button by calling this method, because once I call this method, I am only locating, I am only writing locator for it, right? And locating the web element, right? So close pop-up form button, I have located that and then clicked on that, simply what, just this line, right? This line and then click. And here I have sent keys like this, right? So let me run this script, then I will explain the that constructor. Right, so that much what I have did is done. Okay, now everything is clear about page object model. Suppose if interviewer ask you what is page object model and what are the benefits of it, so your answer should be according to this model, this design pattern for every page, separate web page residing in our website or whatever web application, there should be a separate page class, right? So that we can write all our locators in place where we can use multiple times. We can, and from using this model, our code maintenance, code reusability will be better, right? So this is your, this should be your answer. Now it's up to him. If you want to ask more things, you then otherwise this is sufficient. Okay. If he's asked that, can you write code for this? So this should be followed. Okay. Now you guys ask about why this dot driver is good. This was first question, right? See, if I was not passing this driver from here, right? Suppose I will comment this line. And second question also will be completed in same answer. So both of you should pay attention here, right? So, and this constructor I am not creating. Okay, error is not coming. Just run this program. Before running, let me print here something. Driver value. Yes, and this is skip. See, it has redirected to flipkart.com, but it has not clicked on pop-up or it has not typed any laptop here. Now come to this console and see the error. Driver value and then null. Now how it's possible? We have given the driver value here, flipkart.com, right? Why this is null? Because here in this class we have given driver value flipkart.com, right? But in this class have I given any flipkart.com information? No, this is separate class and it doesn't know about any that information, right? See, this just I have declared web driver and driver, and why I have declared? Because I have to return a web element, right? And this is a locator, right? And if you attach driver information with the locator, means that it will be your house, your web element, right? So driver dot find element and locator value, it creates the web element. That's why I have created driver object here, but I have never given that information to driver object that this driver is related to flipkart.com. So once I have launched my browser, so through this information, first line of code what run, first of all driver setup, then driver object gets created, then driver actually redirected to flipkart.com, right? It redirect open and flipkart.com, right? It came to flipkart.com. Then I have created home page object, right? I have created home page object, right? And I have called the close pop-up form button method, right? So it came to this method, it came here close form method, right? Now it came here driver value null. So which driver variable this is actually this variable doesn't know about any that flipkart information, right? And you want to say that just click on that, so where it will click? It doesn't know about the flipkart.com, but still it's writing locator for this, at that's something different thing. But see, this locator resides where? It doesn't know, because this driver is null. So you have to tell that you are in flipkart.com and in that place just find this locator, otherwise whole universe is there to find out this locator, right? So you have to tell this driver that you have to find this locator. Suppose if you ask me any place and I say just go there, but you will still ask which place, right? Simply here, this is address, but in which country this door? So this is address, this driver is null. So my responsibility is to pass this Flipkart information to this driver as well, right? So that's why I have created. And how can I pass? Now two options are there, right? You are calling this method, and you can create web driver here. Just write web driver, right? And then just pass. Now run it. It will click on close button. But it will not type your Flipkart. It clicked on close button, right? But it hasn't typed any laptop here. Why? Because see, it says that this driver was passed to this method. It came to this method. And this is local variable, right? If this is local variable, then only this method will be knowing about that flipkart.com. What about this search box where it has to type the laptop? It doesn't know. So here you have to again receive, and from here you have to pass. This is second way, and the best possible way is that just pass instead of passing here, pass inside the constructor. But is there any construct? Let me remove this so that error will be gone, right? So best possible way is to pass inside constructor, but this constructor is parameterized constructor, right? In this class, is there any parameterized constructor? By default, Java constructor, default constructor is there, right? So in this class, whether there is any parameterized constructor? No. So just create that. So I will click here, automatically it will create, or you can create, right? This was answer of second question actually, right? Now the first question was why this dot driver is equal to driver. See, name this driver to, right? And this, right? But there will be no ambiguity then. But if the name are same, and why I am keeping the same name? Because there may be 100 methods, so will be like driver 2, driver 3, driver 4, driver, no. So just keep a single name, right? But see, local variable and the global variable and local variable name are same. To avoid the ambiguity of the same names, suppose in a class, if you have 100 students and 5 students name same as Rahul, so even class teacher's responsibility, Rahul, when you are, suppose Rahul Sharma, so Rahul Sharma first, Rahul Sharma 2, second, third, fourth, fifth. So here in Java, to avoid this ambiguity problem, this keyword is provided, right? So this dot driver is, now see, if I will not use this keyword, what does it mean? Then it means, see, I have a ball in my hand, right? And I pass to Ramesh. What does it mean? I passed ball in my hand to Ramesh, right? A ball in my hand passed to him. You cannot know who passed to whom. Either Vandan passed to Ramesh or Ramesh passed to Vandan, right? Simply, this local driver is giving information to this global, or global is giving to local. If you not use this keyword, how will you identify? Because names are same. who is passing information to whom. That's why now I am saying that this local driver, this one, is passing information to this global driver, right? So these keywords actually doing this task here. Both answers, you guys got it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Just give me a minute. I am just coming, and then we'll start the test engine now. Okay, so this was about page object model, but you guys need to clear your Java concepts more, right? So the question which came, actually all the answers are already present in your videos, right? So once I have covered the constructor topic, I said yes. That same whatever you names you are using, that's different, but page factory, page objects, everything is same. Page factory simply means, see here I have used one class. Page factory must have multiple classes, multiple folders, right? Multiple packages. So don't be afraid of those things. Right, a lot more to explore in this concept. Just I will suggest you to browse in Google, and multiple sites are there. If you face any confusion on that, simply ask me. Right, see, if I'll start briefing each topic in very depth, then your course will not complete. So this course is designed in a way so that you can learn each and everything, and once you will work in your project, this is sufficient to start. But there will be always chance to enhance your knowledge, right? So don't be satisfied with the context, and don't stop learning also, right? So don't think that this is sufficient for us. Any time after this course also, after finishing this batch also, if you feel that you have to learn some more areas in that, you can just drop us an email, and we will get time and organize a session for that, right? But first just go throughout the course and let's complete it. Okay, now this is actually a topic which is going to start test ng. If interviewer start asking question in this from this topic, then what it does, this topic is sufficient to know that whether you have that much experience in Selenium or not, right? So please pay attention. See, what I was doing here in this form, this was explicit weight class. This was, suppose these are your regression test cases, right? This is class A for regression test, this is class B for regression test. I will come here and run this, and this will run our single test case, right? This will run our second test case. So I have to come each and every class and I have to run each and every test case separately. Suppose in your project 10,000 test cases, right? Will you go to each and every test case class and run that? How much time it will consume? We cannot imagine actually, right? So this is now TestNG framework. In a single click, it will run 1,000 of test cases, right? So TestNG is a framework for testing framework which will help you to run your test cases parallel, means at one click 1,000 of test cases running in just one information, right? Run one click, right? So now which test case should run in which flow, right? That you will decide. You can decide your flow also, right? Suppose, because if you are going to test any sign up form, for an example, so what you will do in that place, you have to put some information in each and every text box, in each and every drop down, right? And then only you can click on submit, because this is the execution flow of that particular sign up form, right? So you need some values. Where you values you will get from Excel sheet or from properties file, from other sources, from DB, right? From these places you will get your information. So for that you have to run test case which gets data from the Excel, right? So first test case should run getting data from Excel, okay, that passed, then only form will be filled, then only submit button will be clicked. These are parallel three test cases, and first should run this, second should run this. You can decide these things in TestNG, right? I'm not going to that much theoretical part, but you just need to understand why we are using this. That's sufficient for us. Okay, but before using TestNG, just copy this URL. I'm pasting here. Okay, you have to use this URL. Just go to your Eclipse help, and because you need to install TestNG, because TestNG is third party, it's not related to Selenium, right? Paste this URL here, check this box and click on next. But there will be a pop-up coming and write, if it is overriding the M2 folder, just skip this process in that case, because that corrupted my Maven, right? So I have to reinstall all the things. In my case, all items are installed because I have already did this. In your case, you have to install it, right? So it's up to you. Okay, once you will install this, then it will ask you to restart the Eclipse. Just restart the Eclipse, right? And right click, and after that create a project and start working with the test engine, right? So in test engine there are certain annotations that I am going to explain here. @test, you can note it down, @before test, right? So let me write it in order, @before suite, @before test, @before class, @before, then @before method, @before, @test, and then in all after, class, after method, after class, after test, after suite. This is actually order. Count will be only here. Only @test will be considered as test case. Others are for impacting the flow. Right, guys, I have learned from many sources. It took time for me to prepare this chart, right? Once you learn from anywhere, you will still confused that which test case will run first. So whatever I am going to explain is that flow of the execution first, right? And that same will help you to understand these all the annotations. So how many annotations are present in test engine? You can count here, much more are there, but these are just here. So @before suite, it means its scope is project level. Scope is what? Package level, class level, run before every @test annotation. Run after every test run after run method before running anything, before running any @test method, right? Run before any method in package. Package means you are getting run before any method in project. Run after running all @test methods inside class. Run after running all test methods inside package. Run after running all test methods inside project, and I will cross check once mistype or in hurry I have did some mistakes. See, I will copy this so next time I have not to type this and provide new format of notes. Okay, now let me come to this part first and then quickly let me create a package, suppose regression, right? Inside this regression I will create a class regression 1. I will close this. Another class regression 2, right? You don't need to create main method here, right? Annotations will help you because this actually helps in unit testing, so you cannot create multiple main methods here, right? So just one main method is you don't need to create actually any main method, right? Suppose void method m1, okay. Sys out. This is for in which class? Regression, right? Regression m1 method. And just use this @test. First you will come and add testng library. Sorry, I have by mistake. Just remove this. You have to import testng library, right? Come here, mouse over here. Add testng library, right? And then import package, import testng org.testng.annotations, right? Okay, now this is test case. The method which have @test annotation before it will be considered as a test case. Okay, now let me run it. Then it's testng, right? Test run 1 passes 1, right? And see the format of it. regression m1 method, the you have printed this, okay, passed, right, m1, which method passed, m1 method passed. Method name and test case name both are same here, right? Means whatever your method name is actually is your test case name. So if you start building working in a project, so your test case name will be method name, right? So your method name will be test case name. What does it mean? That if you want to identify a particular test case, then name it accordingly, right? So here m1 method, right? This is regression method 1 class. Let me go to this one. I'll quickly copy it. Paste here. Now for running anything, you don't need to do anything, right? Regression m2 method, right? And see, now just come to this class, run as testng test, run as Java program, no Java, right? Run as testng test. Now this will pass regression m2 method passed. Okay, I have not changed the name here, right? Just run is, I have just copy paste and I have not changed here, right? Regression m2 method and passed m2. M2 is in regression 2 class, m1 is regression 1 class. There may be 100 test cases inside single class, right? This is, I am just giving example, don't be rigid of that only single test case inside a class. No, in test class there may be 100 test cases, just like in a test suite there may be 100 sections, right, and 100 seats, and in every seat there may be 50 to 60 test cases, similar in class also. Okay, this is one package. Suppose I have another package, Sanity. Right click, new class Sanity 1, another class Sanity 2. Okay, now let me give name according to that. Test void sanity 1 and in sanity 2 void. Sanity 2 Okay, now I am in Sanity 1 class and I am running this. See which test case run, Sanity 1 run, pass Sanity 1, right? Method name is pass, means class test, test case pass, right? Now you can say that we are running separately each and every class, right? So what's the difference? No, I have not attached to parallel execution as of now. Just right click in this project, go to testng, right, and then convert to testng. Here at testng.xml file will be created, right? Just click on this file, come on source, and now see, Now all classes will run parallel. Not running parallel actually, but running in one click. Parallel is something different, which I will talk about in next class. Right? See, now here all methods run, means all test cases run in just right click, run as and test ng suit. Suit means project, right? Right, if I am running a class, then run as test ng test, right? And if I am running this test ng dot xml file, all classes inside this project which information are present here are running, right? So suppose you tomorrow you will add one more class here in sanity, suppose sanity 3, right? So you have two options, right click, go to your project, convert to test ng, it will ask you to overwrite, right? But never do this. I'll suggest you to never do this. Right, if I will go to next, right, so it is saying that you the following changes is necessary, but don't override any file anytime. Suppose some configuration are given by some architect and you just override those configurations, right? So don't do this. You just need to include your class information here. Just copy this line, right, paste, and give your class name here, sanity 3, but the sanity 3 is actually present inside sanity folder, right? So copy this sanity and here sanity 3, in which flow you want to give, you can give, right? This is what I want to say, right? So you can add. Now if I'll run this, I will not run this sanity, just wanted to explain if you manually want to add any class here, right? Now see, I will run this and get same this answer, right? All the methods run, okay? Now see this, now I will talk about order. Some test configuration, some cookies clear, anything can be come in picture, right? This is about project, we will not talk about that topic. But see, if I am giving at the rate before test here, suppose I have another at the rate before test, let me come to the testng.xml file. And this sanity 1 is at third place. First of all, what should run? Whatever the added first, right? Regression dot regression 1, right? I am not adding at the rate before test as of now, just to explain you. So how the execution flow goes on, this will come to regression dot regression 1, right? Now regression 1 class will be finded by this test ng. It will go to regression 1. It will see, okay, there is a test annotation, regression 1 method output came, right? This test case actually passed. Now it will come here, say sanity 2, it will run sanity 2, this way sanity 1 answer, and this way regression method 2, the way we have added. Right, but suppose I go to this sanity 1 class and this is actually test, right? This is inside test package, right? Suppose I go to sanity 1 and I say before running anything, just run this method before test. Okay, now let's run. Now see the flow. What should be the flow? See, it will come executing here from suit, no, and it will find out at the rate before suit. I have not given it anywhere. Now it will come to this line at the rate before test, it will find, and it will find, and it will find only in these four classes, because these four classes are only part of your picture, right? So in these four classes it will try to find out any at the rate before test is present. Yes, here it's present. So sanity 1 will be the part of first output. Okay. Then it will come here at the rate class. Any at the rate class present, right? But at the rate class will be find not globally. Each and every class executions flow, it then once it will go to that class, then it will find, right? So don't consider that this is for it will find throughout any at the rate. No, at the rate class, what I have written here, run before method running any at the rate test method, right? And its scope is only class level, right? But the at the rate test scope is at package level. So it will find throughout the package if any at the rate test before test present. But the class scope is only at the rate inside the class only. So it will come here directly and it will find regression 1 and in it will go to regression 1, right? Inside regression 1, it will first see any at the rate class present, no. Then it will run this method. Right, before seeing it, before method is not there, so it will run this method. So what will run output, then our output will be regression 1. Okay, then sanity 1. Sanity 1 already, no, then sanity 2, it will go to sanity 2 and output will be sanity 2. Then next is regression 2. Regression 2, it will run regression M2 method. So this way it will run. Just run this testng.xml file. Sometimes your answer can be come two times. See this one. Or flow should be correct, right? Sanity 1, regression 1, and then sanity 2, and then sanity 1, and then regression 2, right? So here sanity 1 came two times. Can anybody explain
before
why?
Test is mentioned in two classes, then two methods before test.
Yeah, correct. Why it came two times? Because see, first time it ran for what? First time it ran for this before test, that inside this package if any before test method, yes, this was there. And second time it ran as a flow. Why? Because test and it came into the flow of the picture, right? First it came to in this flow, and then second it came in this flow inside classes, right? That's why it ran two times. Okay, because one by one is it starts scanning, right? Suppose I give inside this sanity 2, if I give after test here, Let me run it. And just inside your flow, there will be after test. Here, at last. Running everything from the project, then it will run after test. Right? Just you can see. Because running after this all classes, it will come and see after test, right? And then it ran same. Okay. Now suppose any before class here, let me create one more method. Okay, and run this where I have written insanity 2. So before running this at the rate test method, in where I have written sanity 2 1, right? So before running this at the rate test method, it will come into this before class. Before test, it will run first time for before test, right? And then before running for at the rate test, it will run at the rate before class, right? So where our picture says insanity 1 when second time came, what's the method name? I think that here, right? Let me copy from the output box. Okay. And then in this place I have before this, I will have before class, right? Let's run it before class and then send it. Before class and then sanity 1. So our flow is correct, means we are going right, right? You can see. Right? You can map your results. Similar way, if I will use before suit, then it will run running anything before suit. So everything in before you can just try it out. Okay, and if you face any problem, let me know. Am I clear with this concept? Annotations in TestNG.
Yeah, how to set up a priority of test cases?
That I'll talk about in next class. Okay. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so thank you for attending today's session. Have a nice day.